So this is the Surface Pro 4. I replaced the battery, which I didn't make a video because no need to make a video of putting a battery back together. And it does not hold charge. It does, however, it does charge, but it does not hold charge. So that's one of the problems. So suppliers already sent a new battery across, but it has not come through. And this laptop is supposed to leave today. It's been over 7 days. It's supposed to be a 2-3 day job. You know, part delivery, pickup, etc. Very annoying. So, although the new battery is on the way, I'm going to see if this issue is actually a battery or an issue with this laptop. So we'll find out. As you can see now, the system should turn on. And if I disconnect this, it shouldn't turn off. It does. That's the problem, unfortunately. Okay. That's the new battery I've installed. You can see that label. That's the supplier's label. Turn it on again. Disconnect, it turns off. Although the battery health is actually quite high, it's over 70%. If I remember, it was 54% initially and started charging all the way up. So let's unfortunately do this job again. Okay. Okay, that's a thicker one. And we'll need the thinner one. Okay. Yeah, this is very annoying. I have to do this job twice because of either could be motherboard issue. Oh, come on. Let's try this one. Now one thing is, I don't remember actually trying the customer's own battery before actually removing and doing a changeover. Could have been a problem that existed before. We will know that once we actually remove. And install another battery that is possibly working from another board. Okay. I don't think there was a screw there. Okay. Okay, let's have a look. Now, did I make a mistake in installation of this? No, I don't think so. Okay. So, what we're going to do is source another Surface Pro 4. Surface Pro 4. Battery 2, 5, 6, Surface Pro 4. Yep, okay. Okay, so we only have one. Do the same process. microphone battery had gone. Okay. Basically, we got another Surface Pro 4, and I don't remember the history. Looks like I've taken a chip out of there. So this is a spare parts motherboard. And looks like that's all the screws. Okay. So now we're going to put our own motherboard here. Just to test. See if it's a battery issue or a motherboard issue. We don't need them hooked up, but just for the sake of it. Okay. Let's connect the battery in tightly. So there will be a couple of screws here. Far out. Come on. Okay, this is not expected. What's going on here? Serious? Okay, what's take that guy out. Come on. Cannot believe a simple micro speaker is not going into its position. Okay. This is what happens when you leave screws around. Shit, I'm an idiot. Okay, so this screw should not be here. Okay. Wow, that was unnecessarily long. Okay. Okay, finally, we can do a test. The other one is the client's one. Hi. Okay. Alright, so we've got a charging indicator at the moment. Good. But we don't know the battery health. So. So it should technically turn on, stay on, and if I unplug the cable, it may stay on if the battery is fully charged. If not, it may just turn off. So it's at the login screen, that's why the light is flashing. Put it to sleep, let it charge for some more time. ready, set. So this could indicate a problem with the motherboard, unless I didn't wait long enough. So let's have a look at this motherboard. Diode, where the voltage comes into the battery. So this is actually more like a motherboard problem then. So waiting for a replacement battery probably is not going to help. Okay, voltage mode. Voltage mode, yeah. Oh, interesting. All right, let's power on the unit. Oh, it's already on. Try again. Turn it on. It's already pulled the cable. Ah, that one is not connected anywhere. Sorry, that's a spare one. I think those ones there could be the voltage divider. Really can't remember. Okay. So the board is currently on. No voltage 3.23. I don't think that's what I should be looking at. So, what do we do in this case? Okay, so what we shall do... Okay, let's have a look at the battery connector. Hmm. These guys are hiding under that cover, which I can't access. I've got to remove the motherboard, the extra shields, and check around here what's going on. Okay. Yeah, this is the one I want to check. Okay, so that's the battery. It's probably the DC, maybe. Okay. Okay, so in this case, should have charged by now, right? There we go. Okay, the problem is not the battery. I'm sure it's the problem with the motherboard, unfortunately. So let's have a look. May not need to remove it all. No. Let's focus on here. That guy there. So ideally we should disconnect the battery because there could be some voltage. Okay, so to disconnect the battery, we'll use 10 of diamonds. And diode mode. That's interesting. The other way again. Doesn't sound right. Okay, that's the problem. So that guy is not allowing voltage. Okay. So this is a spare one Microsoft puts for us. Both sides are ground on that. So let's assume that first. So what we're going to do, before that, right, we had that donor board. I don't think I've touched this one in terms of that same diode. The other way. Yeah, so definitely that diode is gone on that one. So what we shall do, where are you? There we go again. That's a good one. It's a bad one. That's done. Okay, wonderful. Okay, so okay, we go back to tired mode. What do we measure? Good. Could be the bad diode. So we're going to repeat the test here again. I don't know if there's any voltage on this battery. Yep, there we go, turns on. Without the charger in there, okay. That's good. So it's actually fixed. All right. Should be okay for a couple of seconds, okay. Okay. One more time. See that? It stays on. Because I removed my finger there, it doesn't have a good contact. Try one more time. Okay, battery is fully flat. Okay. Just let it charge for a bit and see if we can monitor the battery voltage. Not sure if that's the right place to check. Correct, it is. It's actually charging the battery, as you can see. So the point will be to actually leave it plugged in, turn on the unit, and then press down and disconnect, it stays on. Good. Okay, there we go. Problem is fixed. Okay, we'll bring back the battery that I had installed originally. This is the one. I'm an idiot to put a double-sided tape there, okay. I told Mrs. I'll be here only 1 hour, so I got 15 minutes. Because it's a Saturday, I shouldn't really be here. Because I know the supplier of these batteries, generally, I mean, I never actually had a faulty battery so far, not just Microsoft, but other batteries. They're top supplier I always work with. Wow, since 2006, maybe 2007. Jack, it's good when people don't change in companies. By the way, if you're in Australia, you're in this business, supplier's name is Broadway Computers in Victoria. I just hope they don't go out of business. And their choice of courier is very good. I can depend on it to order goods and give a customer a time frame. It's very crucial. Nowadays, everyone wants things done yesterday. Okay, so we can now safely do a test of actually turning on the unit without a worry. Oh, I don't need to. Should have power. Should already be on. See? So confident this job is going to be. Or there. What was there? It's quite long. I think that one. Yep. Because he didn't shut down properly, he's probably in a recovery environment. That's fine. Told you to die, buddy. Why are you still working? Okay, wonderful. Nearly there. Okay, just double check all those connections. We already checked them. They're good. Good. Okay. Needs to be that long one. Okay, so wonderful. This unit is actually now a proper working unit. One more test and then we'll apply our tapes and let the customer pick up on the weekend. Okay, great. wonderful, batteries charged to a certain degree. So now I'm going to disconnect as before, stays on, charges, wonderful. Okay, wonderful. It's probably the microphone. Yeah, good. Okay, turning off the unit. Nice. I'm happy to have resolved this over the weekend. At least this job can go to a happy customer. Okay, wonderful. All right, I'll just test the functionality quickly. Yep, sound works. Brightness is good. Okay, done. All right, so that's about it. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.